The following contest is scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Approaching the ring, accompanied by Sable from Buffalo, New York, weighing 235 pounds, Marvelous Mark Miro.
Wait a minute. Hey, Mark, the ring's over here. I think he's lost again. Well, I don't understand this. Miro disrespecting Sable, apparently dispatching her back to the locker room area. He wants all the spotlight. He wants all the attention on him. Miro has been so jealous of everyone's attention to Sable. Oh, yeah, in your dreams, pal, like that guy. Let's take a look at what happened just this past Monday. Tom Brandy with an impressive victory on Raw, but Mark Miro couldn't leave him late. Miro is still jealous over the attention that Brandy had paid to Sable. And Mark Miro comes in and does a little Tennessee two-step on Tom Brandy after hitting him with that culotta.
Of course, Brandy, formerly known as Sal Sincere. And here comes the Rocky Mountain Monster. Collision course with the artist formerly known as Goldust. That one-on-one matchup will finally take place on January the 18th at the Royal Rumble.
Boy, ever since Goldust, well, he took off, he left his family, then he turned his back on his country and his team at Survivor Series, and Vader is the man that he refused to tag. The bad feelings have grown ever since, and Goldust has done a lot of things to Vader that Vader's anxious to get even for. At the Royal Rumble, he finally has his chance.
Indeed, it could be Vader time in this next matchup with the marvelous Mark Miro. And without Sable at ringside, of course, you can see more of Sable in the next edition of the Raw magazine, which, by the way, is going monthly. A special swimsuit edition available on December the 30th. Two different collector's edition covers featuring Sable and her pal, Sonny.
And I've seen advanced copies of those issues, and you can't see much more of Sable and Sonny, believe me.
Vader at 458. One of the most intimidating, powerful men to ever compete in the WWF. And Mark Miro is still looking to ascend to main event status, and he's having to do it in Sable's shadow, as you can hear.
Well, Miro is going to have to figure out some way to climb this mountain, because Vader has a tremendous weight advantage and a tremendous power advantage, and the only advantage that Miro has here that I see is his quickness. He's going to have to use it.
Vader and Miro both will be a part of the next live WWF event in Madison Square Garden on Saturday night, January the 10th. As a matter of fact, Miro will meet the big Italian Tom Brandy at MSG Saturday night, January the 10th. And again, tickets are available at the Garden box office and all Ticketmaster outlets. And Miro, using those boxing skills to go downstairs, those body shots on Vader, who reverses the Irish whip.
Oh!
And Vader, with that 458 pounds of mass, just knocked down the marvelous one.
Well, that's the way to get to the bottom of things right there. And there's Miro's quickness. He's going to have to keep it up, because hitting Vader with punches is like trying to punch a brick wall.
Miro now up very quickly, sticking and moving, chucking and jiving, shaking and making. My God, I sound like Walt Frazier.
JR, my question to you at this time is simply this. Who is Walt Frazier?
Aren't you a Knicks fan? I guess not. Well, not many people here are fans of marvelous Mark Miro either. Vader down on one knee, and Miro coming right back. Well, a right cross and then a rake to the eyes. Miro doing very little wrestling here.
Somebody ought to remind the referee of that.
Those clenched fists are illegal. And downstairs again, Miro on his bigger, perhaps even tougher adversary, the man they call Vader.
Well, he hadn't got Vader off his feet yet, and it doesn't look like, oh, wait a minute, there is Sable watching TV. It's good she has cable in the locker room.
Sable was summarily dismissed from the ringside area by her jealous, marvelous Mark Merrow. And well, now Merrow's going to climb the ladder here, James.
He finally got Vader to crumple to one knee. He's been punishing the kidneys and the ribs. And boom, there he goes. He's down.
Double axe by Merrow, going for a cover. And Vader kicks out with great authority.
And Merrow better stay on top of Vader, because if he gives him any chance, any opening, any air, and he just did.
Vader now hammering away at Marvelous Mark. Vader using those right hands, and Vader talking some trash to the Marvelous One, and Merrow comes right back and rakes the eyes.
And Merrow, oh, now this is not a smart thing. This is fairly unintelligent.
Merrow couldn't get Vader up and over with a forklift. And there's a suplex. Vader counters, and Tom Brandy is watching this match, maybe doing a little scouting.
Boy, those Italians. They'll get you every time.
As we mentioned, Merrow and Brandy at Madison Square Garden on January the 10th. And a knockdown. Vader, that clothesline.
I wonder who Sable's cheering for. I wonder whose corner Sable will be in at the Garden. I bet she's winking at
Brandy. Oh, that's a big splash. This one's over. And wait. Good Lord, look at that.
What in the name of...
Happy holidays to everybody from the artist formerly known as Goldust and his little love interest, Luna.
And what does that little hat say on his head? I'm free? You couldn't charge for that.
Can you imagine what Goldust, I guess soon-to-be ex-wife Marlena, and his family must be thinking here at the holiday season?
I can't imagine what his daddy must be thinking right now.
Oh, good Lord. A blatant low blow of Delana, perhaps out of desperation for Merrow, and another one.
Ladies and gentlemen, what? The winner of this
good
bout,
grief,
as a result of a disqualification, the man they call Vader.
Vader distracted by Goldust and Luna. Merrow goes downstairs twice, and now look at Goldust hammer away at the man they call Vader.
My God, Goldust has a run in his stocking.
Good grief, why would you be looking there? And a knockdown.
He is on Vader, and Luna is running around like a screaming banshee. Look at that cast.
Goldust has never been more bizarre. And you gotta wonder, this Monday on Raw, in our special holiday edition, what Goldust and his little Luna are going to be wearing and what they're going to be up to this Monday.
Luna looks like a schoolgirl from Star Trek. Look at that.
Folks, oh my, what else is going to happen here? We'll be right back.
The world's toughest fighters gather in Japan as the Ultimate Fighting Championship presents Ultimate Japan. Sunday, December 21st on pay-per-view. See.